Hello everyone, welcome to IIHL Food Studio. Welcome back for yet another interesting and learning video from Chef Harsh. So today we are going to learn about another series of dessert, interesting one which everybody in India likes and are fond of it. A dessert which is quite famous for celebrations, festivals and many more occasions where people love to have. So we are talking about rabdi, alright? So let's see how we are going to make rabdi and look for the ingredients. So rabdi is a very interesting dessert. A base will always remain the same but yet available in n number of flavors and varieties. So what flavor we are doing is a surprise. Stay tuned for the end of the video and we'll see now the ingredients that are required to prepare a basic rabdi. Okay, so we have 2 liters of milk here. This is the base. I have used full fat milk. Then we have sugar for sweetening. I have also condensed milk which I'll be using for sweetening, and then some dry fruits. Our flavor is green cardamom and I have some saffron too. Now let us start the process of preparation for rabdi. In the entire rabdi, the main process is to reduce down your milk. As I've told you, I have used full fat milk which will give you more creaminess, thickness at the end of rabdi. So the basic preparation is just have to boil the milk and reduce it until it becomes 1/4 for a thicker version and 1/2 for a little liquidy sort of a rabdi. Now people like in different ways in different parts of India. Today we are going to make a little thicker version, so I will be reducing it down to 1/4. So let us start preparing. For that I will just start induction. We simply have to boil the milk and reduce it. Now, as you can see, our milk is started to boil. After a first boil, what we have to do is simply simmer down the flame and reduce it for almost till it reaches to a consistency. Now in the preparation of rabdi, this is the important phase to reduce down the milk. At this point, do not add sugar, do not add anything. Once your milk is reduced to 1/2, then we will add our remaining ingredients. Till the time, just wait and watch your rabdi getting ready. Alright, so it's almost 1/2 hour and our milk, as you can see, has reduced down less than 1/2. So we are now ready to add sugar into it. You can see it is nice and thick, it is reduced to a very nice consistency. This is the correct time where we will be adding sugar and condensed milk so that the enough sweetness will be given. So I'll add sugar now, around 1/2 cup, not too much of a sugar because make it too sweet, and then I'll add condensed milk, 1/2 cup. I'll prefer more condensed milk than enough of sugar because it will give you a consistency and a nice color also. So once you add sugar and condensed milk, just give it a stir and again allow it to thick. Now, as I have told you earlier, there's a little surprise at the end. I am going to make my rabdi a flavor of sitaphal, a fruit which is very nice and seasonal in this particular season and loved by everybody. So, one of the fruits that I have selected is sitaphal, and I'm going to make sitaphal rabdi. So, for which I am going to take out the pulp, and once our rabdi is cooled down, we will be adding this pulp into our rabdi to make it sitaphal rabdi. So let's just clean Queen Chappal. Okay, so as it is, you can see our rabri is almost ready, pretty much in good consistency. Always remember another important thing, rabri or a basundi, whenever you cool it down, becomes more thick. So at this stage, I don't want it to be very thick, otherwise it becomes very thick when it is cooled down. So this is good enough cooking for us for the day. Now, finally, I'm finishing with a bit of cardamom powder, which will give you a nice flavor and aroma. I have some soaked saffron, which I'll be adding for richness. And I have some chopped dry nuts, which I'll be adding to make it more interesting. Lovely. We'll just quickly simmer it for a couple of minutes, and then we'll take down for cooling. Alright, so rabri is finally now ready. We'll switch off the gas and we'll just pour it into a glass bowl and we'll keep it in the refrigerator for cooling. Remember, we have to add sitafar once the rabri is cooled. And here we go. So the final step is mixing of our pulp for the custard apple, that is our sitafal, and our cool chilled rabri. So what we are going to do is simply we'll mix all the pulp with some for garnish with our rabri. Presentation, we'll put this into a glass. For the final presentation, we'll top this with some chopped almonds, the remaining of sitafal pulp, and two strings of saffron. Lovely. So here we go. Very nice and fresh, refreshing. Enjoy everything.